Reduce, recycle, reuse. Welcome to Zero Waste series from Infobooth 19 channel. Today we are going to entering episode 3, vegetable broth. Use whole of the vegetables. It is very very healthy and very tasty, and it is a good fit for zero waste cooking. That is, like, we are not going to waste any of the portion of the vegetable, and we are going to use it completely from top to bottom. The entire vegetable we are going to use for this broth preparation. So generally broth or soup or those things, we are not used to it, but once you start having this, you will love it so much that you will not throw any of the vegetable peels. From now on, you will prepare this stock and you can use it for multiple applications, which we can see throughout this video. So for this, I have taken different type of vegetables here along with the peels, and whatever we will cut and throw, all those things also wash it nicely, and you can use the entire portion of the vegetable. You can take vegetable of your choice. If you're taking garlic, take with peels. If you're taking ginger, take with peels. Onion, carrot, potato, beans. So whatever vegetables you have at home, all the vegetables, you can do it. Whenever you're preparing any vegetables or whenever you're preparing any cooking, so whenever you're collecting, you're cutting and keeping everything, put it in one airtight box and store it in fridge. Weekly once or monthly two times, you can use that from fridge, and you can prepare a stock in bulk and you can store the stock in fridge, so that whenever you want, you can just take it and use it for many applications. So where all we can use, those things we can see in this video. So I have taken some palak leaves and the coriander stem and coriander root and little bit of mint. Ensure that you wash it completely thoroughly. So for preparing this, just take a wide bottom pan which is very deep. So I am adding 1 tablespoon of sesame oil or gingerly oil you can add, and all the vegetables you can put in that, and you can just give it a fry. Why we are doing the frying step first is so that the flavor of all the vegetable, the earthiness flavor, will come out slowly. After that, we will start adding water and then we can cook it. So the entire process of this vegetable broth or stock cooking, it will take around 20 to 30 minutes so that the all flavors of vegetables we are going to extract slowly. It is very very healthy, and you can use this broth in various preparations like vegetable kurma, for making noodles and all those things you can use this. So first, after the vegetables gets fried completely, then we can add the greens as well. Why we are not adding greens at the beginning is the greens will get cooked faster. That's why we are adding now this coriander stem and coriander root, little bit of mint, little bit of spinach. You can add everything. So once you try it, you will surely love it, and you will have a self-satisfaction of you're using completely all the portion of the vegetable, and also you will get a great satisfaction, and you will feel more healthy to have this as soup, or when you're taking the stock and when you're using it for food, it will be very tasty. Here I have added 1 tablespoon of jeera. So this jeera is optional, but pepper you need to add, then only flavor will be enhanced. Salt we can add after some time. So once you add this pepper, you can just give it a mix. Either you can add the whole pepper or you can crush it and you can add. Now we are going to add water, and then we are going to close the lid and cook it for some time. So whenever you are preparing the noodles, instead of boiling the noodles in the water, you can boil the noodles in this kind of stock. So what will happen in this broth, if you cook the noodles will get lot of vegetable flavor in it, so that it will taste awesome. So surely you need to give it a try. Apart from that, where else you can use this vegetable stock? Whenever you are preparing vegetable kurma or any vegetable gravy, instead of adding water to increase the volume, you can add this vegetable stock. Even if you add little bit also, it is fine, because we are making in the concentrated form. So the taste will be awesome. So it will be very tasty. Surely you all need to give it a try. So close the lid and cook it. In between you give it a mix. You can adjust the water consistency as per your requirement. So here I have taken like 2 to 3 glasses of water. You can just taste in between, and if required, you can adjust the consistency. The entire house is smelling full of vegetables, and the soup flavor is coming nicely. You can add salt as per taste, and you can close the lid and cook. Exactly after 25 minutes, I am going to strain out this one. So we have extracted all the flavors of the vegetable completely. So just squeeze it nicely and remove all the soup from it. You can just add salt and pepper as well, and you can just drink it as soup. It is very, very healthy. Surely you all need to give it a try. And once we squeeze and remove everything, then this directly, once it becomes cold, you can just directly add this portion of vegetables in the compost directly once it is dried. Now our vegetable stock is ready. Cool it completely and then you can store it in glass bottle and you can keep it in refrigerator. Surely you all need to give it a try. Don't lose any vitamins or minerals from the vegetable skin or the vegetable peel. Everything is very good for health and each has single different properties, healthy properties. In my upcoming Zero Waste series, individual vegetable peels and what are their health benefits, it will be covered in the coming episodes. So surely you all need to give it a try. If you like my video, subscribe to my YouTube channel and share with your friends and family. Be happy and stay positive. Thanks for watching.